Welcome to Utah Valley University. Tonight, the Wolverines take on the Utah State Aggies. Will this week's Great Western Conference Defensive Player of the Week, Sarah Clement, match up to Utah State's kill leader, Liz MacArthur? Find out in a moment, coming up next on UVU Sports Network. Welcome to the Shurian Family Activity Center on the campus of Utah Valley University, home of the Wolverines. Tonight, the Wolverines take on the Utah State Aggies in a non-conference match. This matchup is sponsored by Costa Vida. The Wolverines come into this match tied for first with the University of North Dakota. They do have a home match against them a little later this month. But to get us started tonight, we're going to take a look at some highlights from Utah Valley's matchup against Boise State University. Tyler, why don't you take us through those highlights?
Yeah, absolutely. As we can see, Utah Valley did very, very good defensively. Sarah Clementine and Erica Nish really stepped up in the middle and just dominated. Between serving tough and passing very well, Utah Valley took it to Boise State, just like the plan for tonight is against the Aggies.
Yeah, Utah Valley came out a little bit slow in that matchup against the Broncos, but once they got their feet under them, they really took it to the Broncos that night. So tonight, we're going to get a look at a couple of players that are going to have a big role in the matchup tonight. For Utah Valley, it's Sarah Clement.
This is her third time being Defensive Player of the Week in the Great West Conference, which is huge for her. She's really stepped up her game this year, really liking what she's doing defensively and offensively. For the Aggies, we have Liz MacArthur. Right now, in the Western Athletic Conference, she's ranked fourth in kills and points per set. She's their go-to player.
Yeah, looking to the Aggies to push that ball out to their outside hitter to continue to get big numbers from her. We're going to get a look at some keys to the match tonight, starting with Utah Valley.
Utah Valley needs to maintain effective passing. Don't underestimate Utah State and attack aggressively. Utah State side, they need to get the ball to Liz MacArthur. Being ranked fourth in her conference with Hawaii, a top-ranked team, that's a big number for her.
You bet. They're going to need her to fire on all cylinders tonight to have a chance against this UV lineup. Well, don't go away. We'll be right back with some exciting volleyball here on the campus of Utah Valley University.
I'm Joe Luce, an anthropology student at UVU, and this is my classroom. I'm sharpening my mind and my skills.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest growing, and most dynamic universities.
Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center here on the campus of Utah Valley University. Again, the Utah Valley Wolverines are taking on the Utah State Aggies in a non-conference match. This matchup is sponsored by Costa Vida. Get a look at some rowdy fans over there.
We have the Green Man drum group, so that's very exciting for the Wolverines.
Getting a look at the starters there for Utah State. That was Jocelyn White, the outside hitter. the other outside we spoke of earlier, Liz MacArthur. She is a 6'1 senior. And Sam Atoa mentioned before the match, both of their outsides, very, very skilled veteran players. Rounding out the cast for Utah State. In the middle, we've got Caitlin Van Hoff and Nicole Tyre. As the opposite, Shea Sorensen. Setting is Paige Neves. And the libero is Ashlyn Rogers.
And you know, this is going to be a really fun match for these two teams. Some of these players actually played against each other in high school and had big rivalries during that time. And it's fun to see the rivalry continue up into the college game.
Yeah, there's going to be some exciting volleyball tonight. We're getting a look here at the Utah Valley starters. Number two, Chelsey Heaps, outside hitter. The other outside is Jaicee Kuresa. In the middle, we've got Erica Nish and our spotlighted players, Sarah Clement. Tyler likes to refer to her as Sarah Clementine. And setting is Brookelyn Campbell. And as the libero, they are starting McKenna Tate. So we're about to get underway here. It's going to be an exciting matchup. Head coach for Utah State is Grayson DeBose in his sixth season. And in his 13th season is Sam Atoa for the Wolverines.
And the assistant coach for Utah State, Jeremiah, that you met prior to us starting, this is his first year at Utah State. He was in Missouri prior. And he's a very renowned, very looked upon coach. You know, people like what he does with the players. And I wouldn't be surprised if Utah State comes out pretty tough this first set with their outsides. Their outsides are very tough. But I think with Sarah Clement and Erica Nish blocking as well as they have been, Sarah Clement being third time Great Western Conference defender, it's going to be a fun match.
Yeah, she does a great job of clogging up the middle. And so that might be even one more reason why they try to push that ball outside to their very established outside hitters.
Looks like we have some confusion here with the referees already.
So there's another look at Sam Atoa, again in his 13th year. Been a very successful coach for Utah Valley. Sam played 100 years ago with my brother over at BYU. And was an incredible player. They used to call him Sam the Wham Atoa because he had such a big shoulder.
You know, I heard that he would bang balls with his left and right arm straight down, and that's why they would call him the Sam the Wham.
Well, that might be yet another reason, but he's, I know he brings a lot of heat when he swings. We played against him in an alumni match once, and he about took my shoulder off. And he was like 40 then, for heaven's sakes. So Brooklyn back to serve for Utah Valley. The high two in the middle, you don't see that very often.
Yeah, Utah Valley's off to a really nice start right here. Utah State looks like they had two minor issues with their libero right away, and it looks like they're scooting her over now and letting the outside take up some more room.
Wow, that's something you don't see very often either. Nice touch there. Utah Valley unable to rein it in. That's the danger of doing a little roll shot like Chelsey Heaps did on that swing. It's smart to keep it in play, but it basically sets the other team up for a pretty easy point. Utah Valley showing some signs of confusion themselves now at this point. Yeah, it's a nice job there from Utah Valley trying to play that ball, but the placement was just too good there.
Yeah, that was a nice spot. Brooklyn needs to be a little more ready on defense. Andrew Richards with a nice call. He specifically told me not to call him out
for any bad calls. Last time against Boise State, he made a couple of iffy calls.
Well, he better show up then. Start making some calls. Utah Valley bailed out. They had a little run there where they struggled to side out, but the miss serve there from the Aggies. Chelsey Heaps now back to serve. Assistant coach Scott Lee letting her know where he wants that ball.
Ooh, huge block by Sarah Clementine. That was awesome. That was a great read by her.
Yeah, that was a great block. They closed that up pretty well there. Not really a seam for her to try to find and go through. And Shea Sorensen is blocked for the Utah Valley point. They go right back to her. That's a nice, I like what she's trying to do there. It's a nice high swing, trying to go high hands off the block. But when you go that high and there's no block there, then that creates some problems. Wow, great serve.
Kind of.
Another great block there from the Wolverines. Oh, they popped that ball up. That was like the double pancake there. Oh, and again.
Oh, beautiful up by Liz MacArthur.
Look at that set.
I could see why they like that player Liz a lot. She does a lot of good things defensively and offensively.
Very smart play there from Jaicee Kuresa to go up and over the block of the 6'3", Jocelyn White. Chelsey back to serve her fourth ball. Ooh, I think that was going out of bounds too. Nice set there. Lays out to make that bump set.
Utah State is just, you know, these last three or four points looking a little sloppy. Wouldn't be surprised if Grayson will call timeout if Chelsey keeps bringing the heat on the serve.
Yeah, she's got great placement on that serve, and she's just picking them apart right now. When I spoke with Grayson briefly before the match, he mentioned, you know, our game plan is pretty typical for volleyball. We want to pass well, we want to serve tough. Well, you know, we're seeing early on in this first set that they're struggling to execute a little bit in that good passing area. You know, they're not able to stay in system and make those plays, and Utah Valley climbs out to a 7-4 lead.
Yeah, and that could be due to the fact that Liz MacArthur is back row. But if you have an offense around one person, it's hard to get a lot of wins.
Yeah, you know, they're kind of a two-hit wonder. It's pretty much their two outsides that carry the brunt of the load offensively. And having one of them in the back row right now has got to be tough. Gosh, she looks a lot like Kristen Richards, doesn't she?
That's funny you say that. She does. That's Ashlyn Rogers. She is a Miss Utah MVP for high school volleyball. I think it was maybe actually last year.
Wait, who are you talking about? I was talking about number 18, Liz.
Oh, I apologize. I thought we were talking about number 5. the one that looks like Kristen Richards.
Nice hustle there from the UV libero, but unable to get that ball. Yeah, Kristen was a local product, mom and dad. Her mom was the head coach here at UV for many years. A great hustle there from the Wolverines, but Utah State able to knot it up at 7s.
Yeah, Utah State, you know, caught Utah Valley in a bad rotation, a couple points, and all of a sudden it's tied. When Utah Valley was up 4.
Yeah, 3 before the side out.
Yeah.
Jaicee Kuresa asking for that ball to be a little further outside, closer to the pin. She had to kind of work to get that ball to go back down the line and got a little too much of it and out of bounds.
That's a good shot by Jaicee. And normally she can, you know, have very good success with that.
High off the hands there. Easy ball for Utah Valley. See if they can convert. I'd like to see Jocelyn take a little bit bigger swing on that. That was a nice high set for her. And it's 6-3, you know, she could get up and just bomb away, but goes for the easy roll shot over the block and paid the price. Utah Valley ties it up, 8 apiece.
And Kevin Castle, not here, absent. He liked to call McKenna Tate's
float serve, a jump kicker. That was his favorite term for McKenna's serve.
So I like that.
Let's see if the jump kicker will.
Well, she just scored her first ace right there.
Yeah, provide some more points for Utah Valley.
Wow, that does have a lot of movement on it.
It's a pretty gnarly serve.
That's a nice job there from Utah Valley to score their 10th point. You and I are going to have some running commentary on the Kristen Richards look-alike because you're way off. 18 looks exactly like they could be twins.
You're right. It was 18. I was fooled. I thought you were talking about number five.
Another nice jump float serve, but handled well from Kristen's twin. Nice, down the line. That's a smart and a confident swing there from Chelsey Heaps to go back to that line from basically the middle of the court. That's pretty good ball control and placement there. It's been kind of back and forth so far in this first match. Now Utah Valley goes up again by three.
Yeah, it seems like both teams are playing a little tentatively right now. I'd imagine the next couple of games, it's going to get a lot more aggressive. A lot of tips, lot of mishandled balls. That last ball, Utah State's libero didn't run it down. You know, I kind of wanted to throw a hissy fit just barely, but I decided not to.
Well, I appreciate that. I think we all appreciate that.
But I think the tentativeness will drop relatively soon.
Yeah, bad pass there. Not a whole lot Brooklyn can do. Especially from the back row. Another mishandled ball. Call that a set me pass. Pretty much the only option was to go right back to the passer.
Yeah, that was a good swing.
That's another thing that's kind of fun about that. Typically when that happens, you know, the passer that shanked that ball feels a little responsible and puts a little bit more on that swing. So it pays off and Utah Valley goes up 12-10. Get a look at that swing.
And that was huge by Jaicee. She went right down the line in the seam. That's a tough ball to defend against.
Sam Atoa is having a chat with Jaicee right in front of us. Kind of hard to see what's going on right now. Nice swing down the line, handled easily by Utah State. Wow. Erica Nish.
Huge swing.
That was. I love that that play. That works so well in women's volleyball. The slide right up out past the block and straight down.
Yeah, very effective for Utah Valley and Erica Nish. You know, Rachel Anderson serving. I think she provides quite the spark for Utah Valley when she comes off the bench. It really motivates her team.
Yeah, we're getting another look at that swing. Maybe we won't see that back line, but man, I really felt like that ball was out of bounds. But I don't want to go against Andrew this early in the match. I'm sure he got it right.
Oh, Brooklyn getting down on her knees to set that ball.
Utah State with another chance. Oh, great overhand dig from Chelsey Heaps. That was like a beach dig.
Steve Bell knows about that beach dig. I think he's mastered it.
I don't know about that, but I recognize it when I see it. Utah Valley unable to come away with it. And Utah State trails by one, 12-13.
Yeah, Utah Valley is just playing this side out game like I mentioned earlier. They just need a side out, have a little more control of that ball, and they'll be just cruising like they have been.
Yeah, they seem like a little bit, you know, more well-oiled than Utah State. And if they could just, you know, hang in there and tighten things up a little bit. Well, that was a nice serve, but again, handled well.
That's a really nice shot.
Yeah.
By Jocelyn White.
Yeah, that's the kind of swing Jocelyn needs to be taking pretty much every time unless she's about to fall down. Because it's 6'3 with a net that's only 7.5 feet tall. You know, she needs to bomb away from everywhere.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, she's been doing relatively well with that. A couple, you know, she's got that tape on her ankle. I wonder what the problem is.
Yeah, I wonder. But.
Yeah,
Ooh. That ball was not handled very well from Brooklyn and paid the price. The upper ref didn't like it, called the double contact.
And I like that was a really good idea, I thought, by Brooklyn to go to the middle. Jeremiah Larson and Tyler, the line judge, on camera.
Ashlyn Rogers with a nice serve.
The not Kristen lookalike.
Well, we're going to step aside for a moment. We'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Utah Valley leads, or is down 14-15 to Utah State. Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center, where Utah Valley trails in this first set 14-15 to the Utah State Aggies. In town and coached by Grayson DeBose, they've come to play tonight. Sam Atoa having a chat with his team here, trying to fire them up, trying to minimize those mistakes. They've led by as many as four early on in this set. But it's been kind of a back and forth cat and mouse game thus far.
Yeah, it has been. Utah State going into this timeout. Let's see if they can keep that momentum going.
Beautiful pass. Oh, great up there from Patty. Wow. Yeah, that was a well-played ball there by Utah Valley. Patty Flagg lays out with one hand and pops out up beautifully. Chelsey Heaps with the kill.
Yeah, that was great execution for Utah Valley. They needed that to get this serve to try and create that momentum for their side. You know, and a big, tough serve like that is going to start it off for them.
Nice block by Brookelyn Campbell. Oh, if there's enough room, great job there. Utah Valley able to keep that ball in play, relying on the big block of Sarah Clement or Kristen's twin to hit that ball on the top of the tape and down for another Utah Valley point.
Yeah, Rachel Anderson comes running over here, reaches over our televisions and plays that ball back up. That was huge. That was a huge point for Utah Valley.
That was. Liz MacArthur, her set way too far outside, unable to do anything with it, and gets aced there by Erica Nish. Utah Valley again up to 17-15.
Ooh.
It's hard to tell if that ball was going to keep sailing or drop off the table and land on the back of the line, but it sails just long. Utah State dodging a bullet. Paige Neves back to serve for the Aggies.
Chelsey should have known that setter was back row.
Yeah, she was a little hungry on that. Thought for sure that setter was going to try and come over, regardless of where she is on the court right now. But yeah, knotted up at 17s.
A little miscommunication. I don't think we'll see that again by Patty Flagg.
Yeah, we've almost got three liberos back there passing right now for Utah Valley. A misplayed ball there from Patty Flagg. Nice job by Sarah Clement.
You know, I like Patty's ability to take that next ball that was served to her and pass it well for her team.
It's good to have a short memory in this sport sometimes. Nice pass there from the Aggies. Liz MacArthur with a kill, able to power that ball through the block of Chelsey Heaps. Liz back to serve.
Feeding her in the back row. Let's see if they'll go back to her now.
Yeah, so far the passing has been less than stellar on both sides of the net tonight. Free ball here for the Wolverines.
Huge kill by Chelsey Heaps.
That's a great swing there by Chelsey. You see here, able to go right through the seam of that block for the kill to tie it up at 19. Chelsey back to serve.
Oh, wow. That is just too bad for the Aggies. Just a little miscommunication. Grayson does not like that, so he takes that timeout.
Yeah, that's a smart timeout there from Grayson DeBose. You know, our broadcast today is live on the internet and available on your mobile device, iPod, or iPad. Join us at uvu.edu/UVU TV. The UVU band up top, I can barely hear myself. They sound awesome though.
Yeah, it's too bad.
And they look even cooler.
The green man, that's exciting. We got the wrestling squad down here running around, their spandex looking like the Hulk. So if you're Sam Atoa, you've known Sam for a while now, what are you saying? What is he saying to his team?
He's telling them right now, hey, you guys, we've got this set, we've got this match. We just need to settle down and pass the ball. We pass well, everything else will flow from there. So just settle in. We've got great passers on the back row. Just get the ball to Brooklyn and let her dish to the right hitter, and we'll walk away with a win tonight.
Yeah, you know, I think Utah Valley will do that. Usually they come out pretty confident after timeouts.
The other beautiful thing is they have tough serving, Utah Valley does. They've just got great float serves, a lot of movement. Man, that ball went like up. down.
I think she expected a bigger block than what was up there.
It was like a half a roll shot, half a swing, and so it had the height of a roll shot and almost hit the back wall. Nice pass there.
Ooh. That's unfortunate. They didn't put that away. That was a misread by both blockers. But Utah State still takes away the point.
Hanging around 20-21. Utah State needs to try to manufacture another point here because Utah Valley can side out their way to victory. Wow. It was a bullet pass. Might call it a fast offense.
Yeah, that was it's almost surprised. It almost seemed like Jaicee was surprised by that set.
Yeah, she's very lucky that that bullet pass went right to the center because anywhere else and they were in trouble. So that's the wrestling team over there on the side?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
That's the wrestling squad.
That makes sense.
You know, and I like that the ref didn't call that a double. You know, there's some balls that should just keep being played and some balls that do need to be called.
Yeah, I agree with you there. It's a nice call there by the up ref. Sam's still mad about the tumble that you just talked about. Yeah, let that go. Sam thinks otherwise, I believe.
Yeah, absolutely. I like seeing the emotion by Sam. It's exciting.
Yeah, but you don't want Sam mad at you. That's not a good thing. That's scary.
Well, have you had an experience?
No. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just saying. I'm speaking in the hypothetical. Utah Valley goes to set point, 24-20. Grayson DeBose wants to talk about it, slow things down a little bit. You know, it's not completely out of the question, but they need to side out and score three real points, which is hard to do in rally scoring. To do that, score three real points in a row.
Yeah, absolutely, Steve. Even when the other team is serving.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Well, to find out more about UVU women's volleyball team, be sure to visit wolverinegreen.com, where you can find team stats, photos, and a complete season schedule. That's wolverinegreen.com. Another look at the drummers, the green men. I like this. The Utah Valley fans are starting to show signs of life a little bit.
Yeah, showing the Wolverine spirit.
Yes, they are.
We got the band here, the wrestling squad running around naked.
half naked.
Half naked.
This is a family show. Come on now. Utah Valley closes the door on set number one with a stuff block.
Yeah, that's a tough loss for Utah State. I wonder if Grayson will make any adjustments to his lineup or if he'll stick with his gut and keep that same lineup.
Well, we're going to find out in a moment. For now, we're going to step aside, hear from our sponsors. Don't go away. We'll be right back with set number two coming up next. Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center on UVU campus, where Utah Valley leads the Utah State Aggies 1-0. Just about to get ready to start the second set. A couple things of note from that first set. Utah Valley came away with 6 block assists. Utah State had 2. Neither team doing a ton offensively. Utah State only hit for 073. Whereas Utah Valley hit for 130, so neither team really doing a bunch offensively. Utah Valley with 14 kills and Utah State with 9.
Yeah, Chelsey Heaps is actually doing relatively well. She has 8 attempts and 4 kills, hitting 375, which is very good. I think Sarah Clement is not doing nearly as well as she normally does. I like Brooklyn keeping the middle's active, though. If she can keep those middles active, it's going to open up Chelsea to really to score easily and keep that hitting percentage high.
That's a great point, and I agree wholeheartedly. You've got to be able to establish and continue to feed the middles in order to free up your outsides and your opposites. So You know, and I think a lot of that came down to passing. I don't think either team passed well enough, really, to establish the middle. And again, we see there that first pass only option is to go to the outside, and that ball tries to go cross court and hits it wide. Utah State goes up 1-0.
I think we're going to see a much more aggressive Utah State this set.
Sure. Nice serve and a better pass. Wow.
She just blew that ball up.
Wow. Josh took a little shrapnel on that swing.
Yeah, that was impressive. That was a great swing.
Yeah, that ball was hammered line.
I think Sarah's a little surprised that she hit it that hard.
Nice serve from Chelsea, but passed pretty well. And high off the hands for Liz Kristen White. So Liz MacArthur back to serve. Wow, nice job there from Sarah Clement up high and early.
Yeah, that's a tough ball to stop when she's that high up in the air and that early. It doesn't give the opportunity for the other team to even touch you on the block.
Tough serve, but passed well. See, that's the difference right there. With a tough serve, if you can pass well enough and still run your offense, stay in system, you know, this game almost seems easy.
Yeah, absolutely. And my friend Kenny Ainge, you know, he would say it's establishing the run.
Elaborate on that a little bit.
You know, like in the football, you establish the establishing the run. He liked to talk about the two, compare the two.
No, and you're right, and that's exactly true. If you can't, I mean, it's the same thing with a pitcher. You know, if the pitcher can't establish a fastball, well, then he goes to a curveball. They might just sit on it, or vice versa. You know, you've got to be able to establish one to keep everybody guessing, so they don't just sit on the other.
Utah State takes an early lead.
Oh, wow. Some nice hustle there from Utah Valley, but McKenna Tate unable to bring that ball back into play. Utah Valley up 5-2. Ashlyn Rogers back to serve, another tough floater. Great pass.
Wow. The high two ball works.
Yeah, that again, that's a rare set in college volleyball because the whole block can get up there.
And on this replay, you see that they do, but Erica Nish able to find that seam.
Yeah, she exploited that like a champ. Oh, yeah, Andrew got that. That's a nice call. I saw that too. Line judge on the other side of the court didn't see it. But Andrew, either he saw it or he heard head coach Grayson DeBose shouting it, one way or the other.
Well, there was definitely a touch on that ball.
There was.
I don't know what Tyler Graff was looking at, the other lines judge. He was just kind of spacing it, watching the girls play volleyball rather than his job.
Shay Sorensen, a nice serve, manufactures another point, 7-3 for the Aggies.
Utah State playing tough.
Yeah, Sam Atoa. Looking at his girls, possibly looking to make a change here shortly if his girls don't start passing the ball.
Ooh, wow. That's quite the swing there. That was impressive. That was a really sharp angle, and it was tough to dig. I mean, that was coming fast.
Yeah, that was a beautiful cross-court hit. Utah Valley pulls within three. Kalani Norris back to serve. Wow, nice pass.
That's unfortunate. That's good skills by the setter, number 9, Paige Neves. That was a very smart play by her.
That was, and that's the thing. It's tough when you serve a ball that well and you don't get rewarded for it, but you know, hats off to the Aggies to be able to make a play out of that.
See if Utah Valley can establish this. Wow. Three ball, there it is. Well, Grayson just shot up after that. He did not like what his middle was doing.
Chelsey Heaps just detonates on that swing. A big time kill from their senior. Nice triple block from the Wolverines.
Yeah, that pipe ball, Utah Valley's throwing up a triple block. I'm not really sure what Paige is thinking, giving that set. That's a tough ball for an outside hitter to hit against three blockers.
Yeah, that's something where you've got, you know, pretty gnarly offense going, and that's kind of like your fourth option maybe. But yeah, that they were camped on that swing. I don't think Sam Atoa is real relaxed right now, trailing 6-9 in this second set. It was pretty close all through the first set till Utah Valley pulled ahead. I think it was 20-20, and all of a sudden it was 24-20.
Yeah, Utah State played that pretty well, you know, but unable to execute.
You see Sarah Clement doing a nice job waiting on that ball. If she contacts that before it's on the plane of the net, that is illegal and would be an Aggie serve. But yeah, does a nice job waiting, being patient, and then going straight down. Oh, trouble there. Brooklyn Campbell wants that one back. A rally killer.
Yeah, that's going to kill a little momentum for Utah Valley, but I think they can make that up. Chelsea's serving next. And Chelsey has a tough serve.
That she does. Pretty nice pass there from Patty on a tough serve. Oh, Chelsey got bailed out on that one. That was going well out of bounds. Utah Valley with another free ball. Passed perfectly. Sarah trying to go straight down out of the middle.
Ooh. Yeah, Utah State's having a little block fest, but Chelsey Heaps keeping that high hitting percentage.
Yeah, she's doing a great job on the outside, able to clean up the mess in front of her. The last option there on the outside and gets the kill.
Doing a very good job controlling the ball.
Liz MacArthur cutting off a little too much angle on that swing. Was a nice turn, and it was open over there, but it caught the tape and rolled out of bounds. Wow. Chelsey doing it all.
Oh. Yes, she is. In the first set, she had 7 digs, and
yeah, that's
just
crazy.
That's just increasing.
A beautiful swing from Jaicee Kuresa down the line. Another tough float serve. Utah State just able to keep it in play. It's a nice thought from Kalani, but unable to keep that ball in play. Too much line and out of bounds. Aggies go up again by 1, 11-10. I don't know why the libero would step in front on that one. Oh, barely on the plane of the net, that ball.
That was close. That was very close.
Well, the up ref's got the vision. He's got the angle on that. He didn't see a violation, so Utah Valley ties it up, 11-all.
Yeah, this is becoming that side-out game. Not one team is kind of destroying the other.
Yeah, it's pretty close volleyball. They just keep going back and forth with the lead changes.
You know, I like that triple block Utah State throws up. The outside, Gus has to make sure she's pressing those hands over. And I know one thing, Grayson loves to make sure his blockers are pressing his hands over. And that last replay we just saw, after that play happened, Grayson actually shot up and the ball came by him. He kind of kicked it back.
Yeah, I saw that.
It was kind of funny.
Not happy with his blockers just going straight up. They do need to press to take away those angles. Ashlyn Rogers back to serve. Erica Nish on the slide again.
Erica Nish and Sarah Clement are just doing great. As we can see, the slide is actually sort of like a dance move if you look at it. It's funny to watch. But she has a great form, great timing, crushes it down the line for Utah Valley.
No wonder I can't dance. I cannot hit the slide.
No wonder you can't hit the slide, you can't dance.
Yeah,
right?
Okay, either way. It plays both ways. 13 all in the second set. Shay Sorensen back to serve for the Aggies. Wow, tough cross court floater.
A good placement by Chelsey Heaps, very smart.
Ooh, that was not a pretty set.
No, it wasn't.
That looked like a lift.
Utah Valley is just, I'm going to use a Steve Bell term, of firing on all cylinders right now. They are not holding back anything.
No, Kalani Norris kind of got away with it there. She hit the tape just a little bit on that swing and it threw that defense off and shanked way up into the stands on a ball that might have been playable.
Yeah, Utah Valley continues to serve tough.
Oh, yeah, when that ball spins backwards that many times, that's not good.
That usually means you need to throw out two fingers and blow your whistle.
Yes.
That was a great swing by number 10.
Shay Sorensen. Another big swing high off the hands. Wow.
Great nice hustle swing. There.
Great hustle from the Aggies, but unable to pull it back. Well, we're going to take a moment and step aside, but don't go away. It's 15-14 for Utah Valley in the second set here in the Sherian Activity Center.
Dr. John is a real UVU professor, not an actor. So to tell his story, we hired a UVU student.
Knowledge-based edification increases executive functioning in the frontal lobes.
Yo, dude, UVU is more than an education. It's a life experience.
Exposure to enhanced pedagogical approaches promotes neural activity in the limbic system.
For sick education, get here and strap in.
UVU facilitates the discovery of your personal Weltanschauung.
What?
Dude, you don't know everything yet.
Utah Valley University. It's your university.
Weltanschauung!
Welcome back to the campus of Utah Valley University, where Utah Valley leads 15-14 in the second set. They took the first set 25-20 from the Aggies. Was pretty close all the way, and then Utah Valley just pulled away there at the end. And it was all Utah State at the beginning of this second set, but Utah Valley's able to maul their way back into it, if you like how I use the word maul. But yeah, so now they're up by one halfway through this second set.
The mall fans would appreciate that.
I made that up.
That was really good.
Wow.
A huge block.
Block party.
I think Utah Valley is using that high two ball because they're kind of out of system.
Maybe that's it. Failed out there. Coach Grayson DeBow is not excited at all about that. And one thing I'd really like, I know I don't want to beat a dead horse, but I'd really like to see Jocelyn White be a little more aggressive. On those broken plays where they just throw that ball up in the middle of the court, I mean, come on, get after it. Go just hammer that ball. Yeah. I mean, you swing for the top of that net, good things are going to happen.
Yeah, absolutely. There's a fine line between being aggressive and making errors. I think at this level, they got to be more aggressive and be less afraid of making those errors.
Yeah, you're exactly right. And it's not doing any favors because every time she does that, Utah Valley takes it right back down the throat. So coming up next, our interview with Jared Sumption, the executive director of the Wolverine Club. So stay tuned. So Grayson, pull his team aside to talk about it for a minute. Wanting to find out what they're going to have to do to get back into this second set.
We got some breakdancing going on here on the floor right now. I bet Steve.
So, again, coming up next, our interview with Jared Sumption, the executive director for the Wolverine Club. So stay tuned after the match, or stay tuned after the second set.
This Utah State team is coming to the floor looking very positive right now. Let's see if this positiveness can be reinforcing in their play.
Yeah, it was funny before the match. Grayson's like, you know, we just want to serve tough and pass well, and you know, that's our game plan. And it's real easy to have a good game plan, but the problem is executing. And both teams have struggled a little bit on the serve receive and execution tonight.
Yeah, that was a huge kill just barely by Kenton Vanhoff from local high school Alta.
With the slide again, proving successful. Sarah Clement is just dominating at the net, both offensively and defensively.
Yeah, she's playing huge this match. Excuse me, this set. That first set, she had a relatively low hitting percentage. This set, I would imagine that her hitting percentage has gone way up.
Brookelyn Campbell back to serve for the Wolverines. Great job there from the Aggies. That was a pretty tough serve. They were able to pass it well enough to get that ball to the outside.
Yeah, and that's a really tough ball to defend, especially with that fast set. The hitter's hitting high and deep. It's a tough ball for Utah Valley. If Utah State wants to keep on scoring a lot of points, they gotta keep doing plays like that.
That's exactly right. We see here Chelsey Heaps coming to hit that two in the middle. Three blockers up, still able to put that ball away. That's unfortunate for the Aggies. That was a tough serve, but passed beautifully. And still, setter unable to connect with her middle hitter.
And I like that reading job by Sarah. She knew that the setter was back row, so she stayed down on that tight set. Was able to.
Yeah, Wolverines are just taking care of the net tonight. They are putting on a clinic at the net.
Yeah, it's the Clementine and Jaicee show up there.
That set kind of died inside a little, just trying to keep it in play. Getting another opportunity here. Wow, that's another really low set. I don't know if that ball was going to come or not, but either way, that was a great block there from the Aggies.
Yeah, absolutely. Very nice read by the middle, getting up early and pressing her hands over to get that block.
Jaicee Kuresa off the hands and out of bounds. Utah Valley scoring their 22nd point, going up 5 in the second set.
Utah State made a sub for Rachel Orr coming in from Arizona. And the very first play, you know, it's kind of a bummer that she gets tooled off of that block.
Wow.
And then gets blocked offensively. You know, that's just kind of a bummer.
Hey, but you know, coming off the bench.
There's no easy job.
Yeah, and there's a reason why you came off the bench, and they know that, so they're going to key on her, and that they've done so far already. Wow, nice up by Brooklyn, but nobody there to help her out.
Now that's unfortunate for Utah Valley.
It's a great dig. It seemed like everybody was standing around waiting for Brooklyn to come and set it, and not realizing she's the one that dug it.
What, you can't set after you take your own ball?
All of us are learning that apparently for the first time right now. Nice hustle there. See that right
wow.
there?
I mean,
she didn't hit that 100%. But she put enough on it, she's able to get that ball down for the point. That's the difference right there. It's just that aggressive, you know, go after it attitude that's going to win ball games.
Yeah, absolutely. That was an awesome job by number 12, Kalani.
Yeah.
Very good being aggressive.
Another point for the Aggies, hanging around 19 to 24. Set a little low and outside for Erica, just trying to keep it in play. Utah Valley staying alive here. Momentarily.
Nice, that's a nice swing by Shay Sorensen on the sweep play here, jumping from the back line and able to put it away. That's a good point for Utah State.
Yeah, that's a nice aggressive swing by her. Trouble again for Utah Valley. Well, in that one, you might as well just swing away. If that's if you're going to try and go easy and hit it in the net, might as well hammer it into the net. Sam Atoa, after two or three straight points from the Aggies, decides to call a timeout to take a moment to think about it, settle things down, and let them catch their breath. So what's Utah State got to do to win this second set, Tyler?
Oh, 24-21. That's a tough position for Utah State to be in. It was 18-24, I believe. So they're on a three-point streak right now. The momentum, it's kind of this next serve, this next rally might dictate if they win this set or not. And it looks like a cheerleader just fell, and he looks like he's
It was close. She came down on top of the yell leader. He might be hurt, but I think she's good. Well, our broadcast today is live on the internet and available on your mobile device, iPod or iPad. Join us at uvu.edu/UVU TV.
Nice crowd for Utah Valley this evening.
Yeah, I think this is one of the bigger crowds we've had. There might be some parents, some local parents here that have daughters playing at Utah State, very possible. But yeah, it's a nice group. Gotta love the green men up there, not to mention the wrestling team. Showing off those incredibly hard and workouts that I would never want any part of.
Yeah.
Just one of the reasons I didn't wrestle.
Yeah.
One of the many.
Oh, it looks like the head basketball coach is here as well for the men's team.
Man. And there it is. Utah Valley finally scoring their 25th point to lead this match 2-0. Don't go away. We'll be right back with the third set against the Utah State Aggies.
Dr. John is a real UVU professor, not an actor.
Tell me about
so to tell his story, we hired a UVU student.
Knowledge-based edification increases executive functioning in the frontal lobes.
Yo, dude, UVU is more than an education. It's a life experience.
Exposure to enhanced pedagogical approaches promotes neural activity in the limbic system.
For sick education, get here and strap in.
Okay. UVU facilitates the discovery of your personal Weltanschauung.
So do you want him just in between Tyler and
what?
I? Dude, or do you, want you don't know Tyler everything yet.
Utah Valley University. Okay. It's your university.
Weltanschauung!
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center. Utah Valley University taking on the Utah State Aggies. Utah Valley leading this match 2-0 after just completing the second set. We're going to get a look at some highlights here of some of the action we've seen thus far. Tyler, take us through some of these highlights.
Yeah, we can see this long rally right here. Utah Valley able to control it, and Erica Nish making an error. That's not too positive for Utah Valley on that. Nice, tough serve by Utah Valley. And really, Utah Valley has been playing very, very good volleyball. Utah State has been playing bad. Right now, Utah State is hitting 250, which is a good hitting percentage. But Utah Valley is topping them off, hitting 308. And you can see in the highlights, offensively, Utah Valley just able to get a couple more points than Utah State. Defensively, doing better. You know, I expect that Utah Valley just might win this in three.
Yeah, it might go that way. I mean, Utah Valley has really just put on a blocking clinic tonight, just really controlling the net. Not to mention their two middles, Erica Nish and Sarah Clement, just having their way offensively. Not to mention Chelsey Heaps, who's really kind of done a lot from all over. She's dug a lot of balls. She's you know, gotten a lot of kills and a lot of blocks in the net. So that's kind of a brief look at what's happened so far. Again, don't go away. We'll be back momentarily with the last half of this volleyball match against the Aggies.
Utah Valley University, your life, your beat, your university.
I'm Sylvia Bentley, an anthropology student at UVU studying ancient Peru, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm graduating with a diploma and a resume.
Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center, the home of the Utah Valley University Wolverines. Joining us is Jared Sumption, who is the executive director of the Wolverine Club. Thanks for joining us, Jared.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
You bet. Well, for starters, tell us a little bit about the Wolverine Club.
The Wolverine Club is the fundraising arm for the athletic department. We basically are in existence to raise awareness for the UVU athletics, mostly to bring in funds, but also to raise friends and fill the stands like we've done tonight.
Yeah, you guys actually have done a great job. We were just talking about that. This is a pretty nice crowd tonight. A lot of energy. It's pretty fun.
It's a great atmosphere out here.
So what are some of the benefits of joining the club?
Some of the benefits are we host lunches and dinners, and we also have a lot of fun events that we do throughout the year. For example, next week we have Billy Casper, who is a Hall of Fame golfing legend, who's speaking to the Wolverine Club on Tuesday at noon in the Presidential South Suite. We'll come and you listen to our coaches and listen to some legends in all sorts of sports. Really, we support every single sport that the athletic department has.
That's awesome. Well, that sounds like actually a lot of fun. So I'm sure we've got quite a few listeners out there that want to join. So how do they do that?
Well, what they'll do is you can click on wolverinegreen.com and go to the Booster Club tab. And on there, you can just, it says click here to join. And you can donate with a credit card through there or contact the department at 801-863-7291. We can take any form of payment, and there's a lot of other ways to give. But we're not just looking for money. We're also looking for people to come and support us. Yeah. That's really what we're all about, is just filling the stands and raising money. I just want to let all the listeners know that every dollar we raise goes directly to our scholarship fund that helps support all of our 300 student athletes.
Awesome. Well, Jared, hey, thanks a ton for joining us. Good luck with that. Again, please join the club. It's all about getting the community involved. So get out there and get involved. We'll be right back with the final half of our volleyball match tonight here on UVU TV.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest growing, and most dynamic universities.
Welcome back to the campus of Utah Valley University, where Utah Valley leads Utah State Aggies 2-0. We're just about to get underway here with our third set. And if things go as they have gone, possibly our final set. We'll see if Grayson DeBose, head coach for the Aggies, is able to inspire his players to carry this match a little further. We'll see what kind of tricks they've got up their sleeve.
They are from Logan, so the tricks there, you know. I think you know about tricks from Logan more better than anybody, Steve.
How in the world? We played a couple tournaments up there. That's about the only experience I have with Utah State.
I thought there was a certain girl that lived up there when in your college days.
No. I've got a really good friend from there, Rachel Green, who actually played here and then went on to BYU fame.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, she was a heck of a player. Well, serving it up here to get this third set started will be our setter, Brookelyn Campbell.
You know, we haven't really credited her that much. She's been doing a very good job distributing for Utah Valley.
She really has. I mean, we're talking about how awesome these hitters are and how many kills they have, but all that goes away if Brooklyn stops dishing the ball to them. So, yeah, good call by you. We definitely need to recognize that, you know, she's 6 foot. She's a tall setter, and she's got game, man. She's got great placement and distributes the ball very well for this UV offense.
Yeah, BC is doing work.
Chelsey Heaps killing them with kindness. Little tip over the block on that one. Knots the score up at one apiece. That was a funky looking
something
dump there from the setter. Whoa. That looked almost as funky as the dump. Yeah, Utah State's got to play like they've got nothing to lose, because if they continue to play somewhat tentatively, they are going to be starting the buses up here shortly.
Yeah, it's been a rough road for Utah State. I was half expecting them to play very, very gritty volleyball. Yeah, gritty.
And they kind of have not come out in this third set with really any kind of fire or intensity. You see there a roll shot from their top outside hitter.
Well, Jaicee just bombing away and getting a point.
So that just opens the door on that sort of thing. If you give them a ball easy, they're going to make a great pass, which means they're going to have a great set, open up the offense, and booyah with the kill to go up 4-1.
Not only that, gives the opportunity for Chelsey Heaps to keep on just hammering away serves at him.
Yeah, and she is one of their toughest servers, so you want her the heck out of there if you're an Aggie fan.
That was a nice swing here on the D ball yet again, high hands.
Almost broke some fingers on that. That was a nice swing there down the line. That was close to getting some hands, but nothing doing there.
Yeah, just out of bounds.
So the Aggies pull within one. Nice hustle there for Brookelyn Campbell. Unable to bring that ball back. This is kind of how this match has gone all night. Just one team will jump up 3 or 4 points, and then something happens and they stall out. The other team's up by a couple, and then that goes back the other way.
Yeah, it really said something about their serving, or maybe just not very good side-out percentage, one of the two.
But yeah.
But Utah Valley's, I've been impressed with their ball control thus far.
Yeah, the hitters have done a nice job finding their way around that Aggie block. Not to mention, you know, shutting down the offense of the Aggies at will.
Getting a touch. Did you see a touch on that?
Yeah. Yeah, that ball was slowed way down off the hands there, down the line. So Kalani Norris back to serve. Another tough serve there, not handled well.
Wow, that was impressive. That was pretty awesome of Erica Nish to be able to take it, and Jaicee just turning it wrist away.
Yeah, that was sweet. That was a nice little misdirection play there by the Wolverines. I think the whole blocking unit there was thinking it was going to go out to Erica Nish, setting up that nice cross-court swing for Jaicee Kuresa.
Yeah, just down.
Trailing by one.
A little miscommunication there.
Yeah, I don't know if that was supposed to go to Chelsey, but she certainly didn't look like it was supposed to go to her.
She was surprised it went to her.
Yeah, that's going to be a tough ball to win. Utah Valley kind of lapsing a little here. Nice pass by Chelsey. Wow. There's Liz McCarthy with a great swing down the line.
Yeah, that was a huge kill for her.
You can kind of see that opening up too. Jaicee Kuresa set that block up a little too far inside. Gave her, she could drive a truck down that line. Nice up. Kalani laying out for it. They're trying to see a touch on that, but I didn't see a touch. Yeah. Did you see a touch on that?
No, I didn't. Grace is not excited about that call. He's talking to Kevin about it, Kevin the ref.
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't see it.
I think I saw him slip him a 20 and say, hey, give me some calls.
Next time there's a touch on that ball. Yes, sir. UV showing great hustle. That ball too little too late. Utah State goes up 8-7.
You know, Utah State has Liz MacArthur in the back row, so this could prove positive for Utah Valley if they play it right.
Opening up a lead a little bit here. Almost halfway through this third set. Utah Valley just needs to pass the ball. Pass first. I used to always settle myself down and just say that. Pass first. Who cares about this, that, the other? Pass the ball. There it is. That's nice. The kind of kill we need to see. Brooklyn used to push that ball to the deep middle, and it would get dug so often. But that ball there actually took a swing at it, got the kill there for their eighth point.
Brooklyn has been doing a really good job against Boise State, doing that same thing, that dumb move with her left hand, the hit.
Yeah, and that works great. Nice spot there, Utah Valley.
Erica Nish finding the spot.
Doing a great job, just seeing that's wide open right there. It's a smart play by her, and she bombs, and she hits so hard, it opens that up because the defense is back on their heels, waiting for a bomb. And then she follows it up with a really nice block. That's the thing, Utah Valley, they'll get down a few, but they can come back so fast because they're so good at the net. It's just a matter of being consistent passing.
Yeah, you've been elaborating on that passing. They need some passing lessons from Steve Bell, I think.
I don't know about that. It's easy to talk about. I say I can do it. I said they need to do it. Wow, you see that cross court? That was pretty nice.
A little broken play. Utah State takes the lead by two.
Yeah, that was a cool little dump there by Chelsey, but she's lucky the hitter wasn't ready because it was so tight on the net. She could have detonated that.
That was a really nice turn by Chelsey.
It was.
You know, Chelsey Heaps just keeps getting better and better throughout the season.
Yeah, she's a nice player.
From the La Quinta Inn and Suites tournament up until now, her game has just been improving.
Yeah, I remember I even mentioned something to her after the last match. I mean, she was just getting up that night and just crushing balls. It was pretty fun to watch.
Yeah, it helps when you're a girl and you can jump and with the lower net. It just creates all sorts of openings.
No kidding. Trying to find some hands to go off of out of bounds, but there are none to be had, and Utah Valley ties it up 11-all. Erica Nish back to serve for the Wolverines. Nice swing there, right through the hands of Brookelyn Campbell. See, this should be a pretty decent rotation for Utah Valley. They've got three liberos in the back.
And two great hitters. Wow. There it is.
Seriously. That was actually a really nice serve and just stabbed at there, but made a pretty decent pass. And there's Chelsey again, just getting it done tonight.
Yeah, that's an impressive shot, hitting that line, but it's almost an angle shot. It's a tough shot to defend against.
For sure. Way to control that back into the court. Patty Flagg again. Oh, hit that ball.
Clementine using the old noggin.
I mean, Sarah's pretty tall and puts up a really nice block, but I don't know if Utah Valley would have an answer for Jocelyn White if she would just take a swing at those balls. I mean, she would have so many more kills tonight.
Yeah, that's absolutely true.
I've been harping on that all night, so I'll shut up. Stop talking about it.
No.
I'm starting to feel guilty, like I'm picking on her.
Yeah, you know, that's our job, right?
To pick on people.
To pick on the players. Yeah, Jocelyn, you're right, though. Jocelyn has been a little tentative. Her hitting percentage is not all that great. It's 143 off of 21 attempts. Well, that's pretty rough.
Yeah, she would have a lot more than six kills right now if she would just take some swings. You know, she might make some hitting errors. And, you know, and maybe the stats she doesn't show a ton of errors for, but it doesn't show a ton of kills either. So it's, you know, it's one of those things where what's going to help her team out more, you know? Mm. Well, miss serve there for the Wolverines. 14 all. Swing by Jaicee, another quick attack.
Wow.
What a great swing down the line for Jaicee Kuresa. I mean, that was just quick. That second set came to her so fast and just crushed it down the line. Well, we're gonna take a quick break. We'll be right back. Utah Valley leading in the third set, 15-14. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
I'm Patty Garcia, a geology student at UVU, and this is Engaged Learning. At UVU, I'm learning by doing.
Come join the student section and cheer for the Mighty Wolverines. Mighty Athletic Wolverine League sports passes are now available. Your mall pass gets you tickets to every NCAA home game, free food at the tailgate parties, prizes at the games, and lots of new friends. Get more information on their Facebook page or by calling Campus Connection at 801-863-8797. Go UVU!
I never used to care about college sports. I mean, I go to a game or two, but it's mainly for social reasons, you know?
And how has green fever affected your school spirit?
I never miss a sporting event. You got NCAA baseball, softball, basketball, golf, wrestling, soccer, volleyball. I'm memorizing stats. I'm dreaming about Wolverines. I just bought a pet Wolverine. It tore my dad's favorite chair. It was wicked awesome. No, I don't play sports. I wouldn't want to make the athletes envious. I don't mess around, man.
Welcome back to the Sherian Family Activity Center, home of the Utah Valley Wolverines. Wolverines leading the Utah State Aggies 2-0 and up 15-14 in this third set. All three sets have been pretty tight, back and forth, lead changing a ton of times, but Utah Valley just having maybe a little more experience or moxie and able to close the door on the first two sets. Pretty nice swing there from Liz MacArthur. But an even nicer swing from Kalani Norris on the outside for Utah Valley.
Yeah, Utah Valley's outsides are just really capitalizing on Utah State's inconsistencies right now.
Nice high swing off the hands, but Utah Valley with another opportunity. They are just picking this Aggie team apart. Coach Grayson DeBose wants to take a moment to talk about it, see what he can do to get his girls back into this match, both physically and mentally. Only trailing by three in this third set, but it feels like more than that, especially being down 2-0. Well, join us for our next broadcast, Wednesday, November 16th, where the UVU men's basketball team will face off against Grambling State University. You can watch it live on UVU TV and on Fox College Sports Friday, November 18th at 5 p.m.
Grambling stay, I wonder where that's at.
I do not know. Those guys are legit, man. I like the green men. Those guys are good.
It's fun for Utah Valley to have some sort of a band, you know. It's even more fun that they're dressing up in green suits and playing funky beats, getting the crowd involved.
You know, if I was going to be in the band, I think I'd have to be a drummer. That's just a cool thing. Like, I couldn't play the tuba or the clarinet. No offense to you out there that do play those instruments. That just wasn't for me.
You don't have the figure for the tuba.
Wait, what does that mean? Is that good or bad? I don't know how to respond to that.
Ooh, Kalani dodges that.
Diving out of the way. McKenna Tate with a nice serve. Utah Valley goes up 4 late in this third set, 18-14. Nice soft block there from the Wolverines. Back to Jaicee. She's dug. Nice swing. You know, Kalani Norris has struggled a little bit tonight on the outside, but that's 2 kills in a row for her, and very timely kills at that.
Yeah, Kalani, even with the not high hitting percentage like Chelsea, she's still hitting better than the outsides from Utah State.
Yeah, and that's saying something. I mean, that was really, you know, Coach DeBose mentioned that they were going to rely on those outsides pretty heavily to get the job done tonight. And if their numbers are down, you know, that's not a good sign for the Aggie offense. Nice pass. Oh! Talk about shrapnel.
Replay.
Somebody got hurt too. Oh, I think she came down on somebody.
Let's see if we can see this.
Oh, I hate watching this kind of stuff.
It's up and then.
I don't even want to watch.
Oh, nothing happened. Couldn't see it. Oh,
she had to get her ankle or her knee. It's one of the two.
Oh man, that is a bummer.
Oh, poor thing. Man, I hate injuries. It looked like she got her ankle. Oh, what a bummer. I hate to see that. You know, these girls work so hard. You know, they're the top of their game, the height of their career. You know, and then to go down for an injury, it's a bummer. Nobody wants to see that.
Absolutely. It's unfortunate, really. I mean.
Well, last year, you guys had how many injuries for the UV's men's team?
Yeah, last year, Utah Valley Men's Volleyball Club team had four or five injuries. I'm not sure.
And all ankle, right? All ankles?
Three ankles. It was 3 ankles. Actually, 4. And then Mike, our setter, got sick with a disease. I'm not sure what it's called.
The disease. Okay.
He threw up a lot.
Maybe he had the swine flu. Maybe he was eating too much bacon. Is that how you catch
that's
that?
That's what it was.
Well, we are at timeout again because Utah State is hanging on, trying to figure out a way to slow down the train that is this UV offense. Well, if you missed any of the action today, watch this broadcast and many others on UVU Sports Network's website. Visit www.uvu.edu/UVUTA/UTV/archive. Yeah, I hope you wrote that down and saw that on the screen because I didn't explain it very well. But that's a long URL. Get there, and then you can see lots of cool stuff. Get there with no help from me.
Like these green men drumming away.
Yeah, they're in my head. It's their fault. Sam Atoa 4 points away from a sweep here at the Utah State Aggies.
Yeah. Sam has got to be happy with his team right now. They are playing the type of volleyball that I think that he wants him to play. Granted, they had a couple of going back and forth with points. Utah Valley's able to just take it away at the end every time in all three sets.
Yeah, it seemed like every set was really close right up until the end, and then Utah Valley would pull away and win handily. But and this one's even more so. It's not even really that close. Normally it'd be around 20, 21, something like that. Not 16 to 21. I think the wheels are starting to come off here for Utah State.
And with that injury, wow. That injury doesn't help either.
No, that's a morale killer right there. Or, you know, the girls will step up and, you know, try to win one for the Gipper kind of thing.
You know, that's the, I want to say third, but maybe the only second time that's happened where the outside hitter will hit that deep corner and no one's there. I think McKenna Tate is absolutely athletic enough to get there.
Yeah.
I think it's just
it seemed like she hesitated just slightly before she went after that ball. 22-17. Kalani Norris back to serve. Nice pass there. And there's a nice swing from Jocelyn, able to get that kill off the hands and out of bounds.
Yeah, Brooklyn was right there, just needs to press that right hand over.
I mean, did you see how high Jocelyn was when she contacted that ball? Mm. I mean, man, she should just be crushing balls from anywhere. That's like what, like a 6'9 guy in volleyball maybe? I'm trying to think.
Yeah, that's probably
the equivalent.
You know
what I mean? Like that guy's going to bomb from the bench. He doesn't care where he is. He's going to swing away.
Yeah, absolutely, unless the other team's playing defense like
unless the bench is really good, yeah. 22-19. Now Sam wants to talk about it. Doesn't like that they're kind of inching back into this set. Still in the driver's seat is Utah Valley right now.
Yeah, that's how teams come back to win with deficits like that, just chipping away points.
Yep. That's the thing. I mean, you can kind of lull an opponent to sleep and not even realize that you're climbing back in, and next thing you know, you're knocking on the door, and they're the ones on their heels. So that's what Sam's trying to avoid right now by calling this timeout.
Yeah, he's not talking. He's not even talking too much. He's kind of just letting the crowd get wild and letting some minor feedback happen with a couple players.
Maybe his wife's at home waiting for him to get home so he can help fold the laundry. So he's just trying to, he's stalling.
I don't think he doesn't want to get home to fold the laundry. Or maybe you slipped him the 20 to stall, so
that's
you wouldn't
right.
have to go
yeah.
home and do the
I only make that joke because I know that's my reality when I get home tonight.
Hey, that's not too bad. That's you got to.
I keep telling Sam, dude, call another timeout.
Sam's going to take one for the team.
That's right. Well, there's a lot of energy in this building tonight. It's a lot of fun. The crowd's into it. The Green Men certainly are into it. They sound awesome up there. Well, Ashlyn Rogers back to serve.
Not Kristen Richards, mini me.
Kristen, number three. Yeah. Great swing from Erica Nish, going high and tooling the block out of bounds down the line. Now back to try to serve it out, 23-19. Nice pass. That's it right there. I mean, again, you see a perfect pass. You see the offense open up, the blockers on their heels, not knowing where to go. And sometimes this game just looks so easy. Like, why don't we do that every time?
Yeah, why do we struggle these last three or four points in this rotation?
The last three sets.
Yeah.
Utah Valley, one away. The fans are on their feet.
Taking the sweep to Utah State.
Brookelyn Campbell back to serve it out. And yay, that she does, off of Liz MacArthur. Our spotlighted player of the night gets a shank on her for the final point of the night. Not the way she wanted to go out. Utah Valley came out and played some pretty nice volleyball tonight.
Yeah, Utah Valley, very impressive play tonight.
Yeah, that was a nice win for Coach Atoa. For the Utah Valley Wolverines, a sweep of Utah State. Get a nice look at the players out there on center court singing the fight song. Well, don't go away, we'll be right back. We're gonna have a quick interview with head coach Sam Atoa after these messages.
I'm Joe Luce, an anthropology student at UVU, and this is my classroom. At UVU, I'm sharpening my mind and my skills.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Welcome back to the Shurian Family Activity Center, home of the Utah Valley Wolverines, where Utah Valley has just swept the Utah State Aggies 3-0. Joining us right now is head coach Sam Atoa in his 13th year. Sam, that was a pretty impressive victory over a nice program.
Yeah, you know, happy, you know, it's just kind of speechless right now because I felt like the girls, they really stuck to what we talked about. And even though when we were making some mistakes, it's all part of the game, but they were able to respond and come back. And every single set, we were the better team at the second part of each set. And we were able to kind of embrace it and take control of it. So happy to the girl, you know, that the girls were able to stay disciplined on that part and be able to control both sides of the net.
Yeah, you guys did that. I mean, you held their spotlight player, Liz MacArthur, to a 105 hitting percentage. You know, that's that says a lot right there. We'll get a look here at some of the highlights from tonight's match. You guys absolutely dominated at the net. You guys put on a blocking clinic all night long and really just shut them down. As a team, they only hit 173. So a nice job. You got a great effort out of Chelsey Heaps. And of course, your middles played so well tonight. Both Sarah and Erica just got it done. And a nice job by Brooklyn, you know, getting that ball around and dishing to pretty much everybody on the team. And just, you guys played great volleyball tonight.
Well, you know what? I mean, you just kind of, you go from one player to, and then, oh, somebody else did, and somebody else. I mean, it was. Everybody contributed to our success today. They swung well, they blocked well, each one of them. And, you know, JC herself had a very, very good match and did a really good job both defensively and offensively. So really happy at the girls, you know. We really, we served tough and took them out of system, and we were able to kind of control that part of the game. And so, just thrilled at the effort that they all contributed to making this possible tonight. Uh, Didn't expect that we would sweep them in three. However, we're very, very capable of being able to play good volleyball. And they did tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I was saying to Tyler earlier tonight, sometimes it's good to have a short memory in this game because there were some passing issues here and there in the match, but your girls just got right past that onto the next play. I should have mentioned, Jaicee, she led the night with 13 kills, led the match. So, yeah, great night from her. I mean, you guys really, on all aspects of the game, you guys got it done tonight. Again, with a sweep over a nice program like that, that's a nice night for you guys. So congratulations on your win, and thanks for taking a minute with us.
Absolutely. I appreciate everybody's support and coming out. And this was to beat Utah State. You know, they're a good team, a very good team. And I'm really proud of the girls and how they responded and played well after a tough loss at Boise State on Tuesday to be able to come back and own our own home court. So congratulations to them.
You guys have one more big match here at home against the team that you share the lead with, right? University of North Dakota?
Right. We have our last two regular matches, home team matches, are against Southern Utah and North Dakota. And so
predictions?
Both of them are good. Well, you know, the girls are playing really well, and I like our chances. I really do.
Right on, Sam. So, well, keep on keeping on. And again, nice job tonight. Nice job by the Utah Valley Wolverines sweeping Utah State 3-0. We'll be right back.
Welcome to Utah Valley University, home to an educational philosophy that engages its students in hands-on, practical education. I invite you to learn more about one of Utah's largest, fastest-growing, and most dynamic universities.
Welcome back to the Sherian Family Activity Center, campus of Utah Valley University in Orem, Utah, where Utah Valley just took Utah State to school, sweeping them in three straight sets. This broadcast is produced by students in the Digital Media Department at Utah Valley University. For my co-host, Tyler Whittison, we're signing off from a great season here. A couple of other home matches here, so come on down and watch. But for now, we're shutting it down.